G'day footy heads, welcome to another edition of Behind the Play. I'm David Zafina and I'm joined by my co-host Corey Wassell. Corey, how are you?
Brilliant Dave, and a pleasure to be here as always.
Absolutely mate. Well, it's almost finals time, it's just about upon us.
It's come a week early Dave actually. There's six teams in three massive games this weekend. First up, the Hawks and the Dons fighting for that final spot in the eight. Then the Crows and the Blues fighting for a home final. And let's not forget about the Dogs and the Pies fighting for third spot and a chance to play a wobbly Geelong Football Club and give themselves one brilliant crack at this year's premiership.
Well, that's right mate, it's going to be a massive week. It's also going to be a massive show. We're going to be joined by special guest Neighbours star Sam Clark. But first we're going to cross to the boys down at the Lexus Centre. James and Daniel, how are we boys?
Good, thanks guys. We're here at the Lexus Centre, the home of the Collingwood Magpies. Now according to the newspapers, they're the new premiership favourites and they take on the Bulldogs this week for that vital third position spot. James, what do you think about it mate?
Look Dan, it's going to be a massive game. Collingwood and the Dogs, they're both in hot form at the moment. Collingwood's only lost one out of their last 13 games. The Dogs, they're on fire as well. And I tell you what, if they got Geelong or St Kilda in the finals, I think they'd be pretty happy because both of those teams are looking very wobbly at the moment. But I'll tell you what, we caught up with Mick Malthouse at his press conference. Let's have a look at what he had to say.
You've had the experience of it before, I guess, with Anzac Day off and midweek where you've had a short backup. Does that help you in this sort of situation, I guess?
For this game or the next game?
Well, the next game, I guess.
The next game, I'd be terribly surprised. I can't say, because I haven't seen the draw. But I'd be terribly surprised if there wasn't a minimum of 6 day break, yeah, given to going to the final series, yeah, playing one of the first or second, and history shows the AFL look after and should do look after the sides that have finished 1 and 2.
The Magpies had a light training session today. Star midfielders Leon Davis and Alan Dardak were both missing in action. However, no concerns for the Pies faithful. Both will be fit and ready to play come this Sunday. And while the experts say Collingwood's the favourite, the Dogs have been gifted with an 8 day break while the Pies have only had 6. Despite the shortened break, Mick Malthouse denied that Sunday's game would be a warm up for the finals. The big talking points for this game, fullback for the Dogs Brian Lake will be feeling the pressure when he lines up against Collingwood full forward John Anthony. Lake has been in fine form this season, however he is currently out of contract and questions are now being raised over the fullback's future post-2009. There's no doubt he'll be desperate to answer his critics this Sunday. Collingwood will also be looking to add Travis Cloak to their forward line this week in the hope that their tall marking forwards will make the difference. The Dogs are without a tall marking option and will be relying heavily on their rotating midfield to get the 4 points, but more importantly, steal that third spot from the Magpies.
Nick, earlier in the season when you were going through the sort of rough patch, you made a point of saying the players shouldn't worry about what happens outside the club publicity. Do you still take that point of view now when it's actually good publicity and telling saying how good the players are going?
Absolutely. More so.
Well, there you have it, guys. There's Mick Malthouse's press conference. Pretty straight to the point, James.
Yeah, it's a good attitude to have, Dan. Collingwood are avoiding no one in September. They're here to win, so good signs.
Without a doubt, it's going to be an absolute cracker of a game. Then we're going to cross now back to the boys, Corey and Dave, who are back there at the MCG. How are you going over there, boys?
Good, thanks, Dan. Now, we're here at the home of football, Corey. Finals start next week. So many questions to be answered still. Mm. The Saints have got the wobbles.
They do, Dave. Two losses out of nowhere, but don't despair, Saints fans. I think they'll be right and will definitely give it a massive shake come the right time of the year.
Well, Geelong, so many injuries at the moment. Can they pull something out of the hat?
I don't think they can, to be honest, Dave. Injuries at the wrong time of the year and some battle scar wounds from the past 3 years that are just adding up at the wrong time.
The Pies, so much hype around them at the moment. Mm. They're up in arms. Can they do the impossible?
Possibly they can, Dave. 12 of the last 13 and coming with a rush, there's no doubt they'll be thereabouts.
And the Bulldogs, are they looking for a fairy tale finish?
They could be. They're looking for one and they could be the Cinderella story. Not since 54. Well, who knows?
And I guess there's also the wild cards, Carlton the Crows. Mm. Can they pull some massive upsets in September?
Oh, maybe one or two, but that might still be a stretch. Look, for both of those clubs, young list, one finals win would be fantastic for their development.
Absolutely, mate. Well, it all starts next week. But before that, there's a big clash here on the weekend. At 2:10, the Bombers and the Hawks square off for that last spot in the eight. What are you thinking, mate? Who's going to win?
Huge game, huge stage, could go either way. One of them will sew up that last spot in the eight, but I can't see them going any further.
Yeah, I tend to agree, mate. Hopefully the Bombers can get over the line. Stay tuned, guys, for part two, where James catches up with Neighbours star Sam Clark. Until then, I'm Dave Zafina.
I'm Corey Wassell.
And you've been watching Behind the Play.